A crucial aspect of the $407.5 million Southern Expressway duplication project is the extension of the 9 cross bridges and 5 footbridges that cross the expressway. To ensure there are alternative east-west routes available for traffic, we are extending every second bridge during the first half of the project. The others will be extended next year following completion of the first 5. We are very conscious that these closures are disruptive for the community. You might like to know a little more about what's happening behind the barriers to deliver these bridge extensions. The bridges currently being extended are those crossing the expressway at Seacombe Road, Darlington, Moore Road at Ranella, O'Sullivan's Beach Road at Lonsdale, and Elizabeth Road at Christie's Downs. We are also extending Lander Road at Trott Park using a precast concrete arch. While each bridge is in some ways unique, the extension works follow a similar series of coordinated steps with some variation for each individual bridge. The first step is to temporarily support the multitude of utility services mounted on and approaching the existing bridge. We've also been able to temporarily cut and cap some of the mains while the weather is cooler. Next, we have to support the western end of the existing bridge to allow removal of the western abutment. This involves constructing a temporary traffic barrier to protect the works from any errant vehicles and a temporary footing for the props. The bridge beams need to be stiffened to allow us to jack up the bridge off its bearings and to prop the structure. Here at the Seacombe Road Bridge, we've completed the propping works and the 700 ton bridge deck is now supported on these props. We can't be too thorough with these temporary works given the loads and the risks involved. Once the bridge is temporarily supported, we can then demolish the western abutment, expose the end of the concrete deck, and excavate the soil to make room for the new carriageway. Next, we'll install piles and concrete footings for the new bridge central pier and western abutment. Construction of the new western abutment also involves soil nails and jet grouting to stabilise the adjacent earth embankment. Following completion of the substructure, the next step is to install the steel beams for the extension. The new beams are prefabricated off-site from 25mm steel plate and are welded to the existing beams to form continuous girders over the full length of the new bridge. The girders are then lowered onto bearings on the new central pier and the temporary props can then be removed. The final steps in the bridge extension process are to complete the new concrete deck and parapets and reinstate the services and approach roadway. In parallel with this construction, we are managing the logistics of keeping 35,000 vehicles a day moving on the expressway and seeking to minimise the inconvenience to east-west motorists. Whatever the challenges, we are working hard to deliver a 24/7 two-way Southern Expressway by mid-2014.